My name is Cade Wheeler, your ASI student body president. Hello, incoming first year and transfer Broncos, and welcome to Cal Poly Pomona. I'm so excited to welcome you to the University Quad for Broncos Belong, new student convocation 2024. At this very location earlier this summer, over 6,900 students walked across the stage and graduated from our university. Today, in this quad, your journey begins. But what lies ahead? Late night study sessions at the library, meeting new friends and making lifelong connections, joining a club or organization, and finding a home away from home. You're probably feeling a million emotions right now. I know I did. Excitement, anxiety, and uncertainty. Embrace them, and know they are all part of the journey. ASI, or Associated Students Incorporated, has been transforming student lives since 1963. ASI and the Division of Student Affairs will be an integral part of your experience at CPP, including student engagement, leadership, and a wide range of student life programs and services, including recreation and well-being, our student union, activities, student government, clubs and organizations, a food pantry, and a children's center. These are resources for you to make the most of your time here at CPP. Take advantage of them. You'll find students just like you. You'll meet students who have the same questions, the same doubts, the same excitement you share. A student experience that you'll never forget is out there. You just need the courage to make it. I'm so glad that you've chosen to join the Bronco family. Now please welcome President Coley to give the opening address.
Thank you. Hello, and welcome to Cal Poly Pomona. And in the coming days and weeks, you're going to receive a lot of information. You're going to hear from various university leaders and staff members, begin your classes, and start acquainting yourselves with our campus and the journey ahead of you. And that is why I wanted to speak with you today. Before your workloads ramp up, before the year gets too busy, I wanted to welcome you to your new home and to tell you that you belong here and you deserve this opportunity. And for some of you, you will be the first in your family to attend college. For some of you, you're leaving behind a single parent and your home that needs your help and support. And that was my story as well. And for some of you, you arrive not knowing what lies ahead, where this journey is taking you, or who you want to be as you grow and develop. Well, honestly, I never could have anticipated that this is where I'd be one day. And it was due to an undergraduate university professor who said, you should go to graduate school. And I didn't know how or why, but she guided me, and I am grateful to Dr. Carter. But I did know that I belong. I did know that my hard work and the support and sacrifices I received from my mother and grandmother would not go wasted, and that I would rise up, work hard, and succeed, even though I didn't always know where I was headed. And so I am here today to tell you that you belong. This is where you belong and where you matter. You are now part of a vibrant, supportive, and diverse community. Here you will find not just classmates, but you will make lifelong friends and mentors who will travel this path with you. Individuals who will help you grow and support you when times are tough. Individuals who care as much as I do about your continued success. And you are here because you have demonstrated remarkable potential. You're here because you earned it. And you're here because you are going to succeed in whatever you put your mind to. The road ahead will have its ups and downs, as I had in my undergraduate and graduate program. But with determination and perseverance, you can and you will make it. And you will be so proud and happy when you do. So let me again say, welcome to Cal Poly Pomona. I can't wait to see you grow, excel, and contribute to our campus and beyond. Thank you.
Now please welcome to the stage Provost Terry Gomez.
Buenas tardes, ¿cómo están? I know it's hot, but we're gonna get through this together. Welcome, Broncos. My name is Terry Gomez, and I serve as your provost and vice president for academic affairs. The term provost signifies that I am responsible for managing the academic experience that you have here. I'd like to warmly welcome you as the newest members of our community. Today, you join a community of scholars dedicated to learning, discovery, and innovation. You are stepping into a proud legacy of academic excellence. When I transferred to UCLA, I was so nervous that first week, month, year. I kept saying, somebody pinch me. I don't think I belong here. They must have made a mistake. But they didn't. I did belong there, and I was able to succeed because I found a community of support, a community that helped me learn. I worked with professors, and it made all the difference for me. You are embarking on a journey of self-discovery. Throughout this year, you are going to learn so many new things. You're going to delve deeper into your chosen field, and you're going to start to think about ways you can contribute to our university, your university. I am absolutely delighted to think about the incredible journey that lies ahead of each and every one of you. Realize that you have immense potential that can be harnessed to achieve just anything you dedicate yourself to. That's why you got here. If you're feeling a little uncertain or unsure, that is so normal. Please know that everyone here, everyone, believes in you and in your success, and we're here to help you every step of the way. The effort you've put in to arrive at this moment is commendable, and you deserve to feel an enormous sense of pride, and I know your families do too. My recommendation as you begin the fall semester is to keep in mind that learning is always collaborative. Make connections with your professors, get involved with study groups, and take advantage of the many academic resources CPP has to offer. It may be a little intimidating to venture beyond familiar territory, but I encourage you to challenge yourself, to get involved, join our incredible clubs and organizations, and participate in campus events like this one. Connecting with your peers is so important. Not only will this help you in the classroom, but it'll help you build a network that can support your personal and professional growth. I am thrilled that you chose Cal Poly Pomona to help you achieve your academic and professional goals. I cannot wait to hear all about the things you will accomplish this year. Go Broncos!
One of the themes you've probably picked up on is that we want you to find a community and truly feel like you belong at Cal Poly Pomona. So we asked some current students to share how they found a home away from home at CPP. Take a look.
We've been in your shoes.
And we know how you're feeling.
Lost. Proud.
Excited.
Inspired.
Uncertain.
Optimistic.
And we've all taken different paths.
But know this.
At Cal Poly Pomona,
you belong.
You matter.
Your next journey has just begun.
Because college is more than just classes.
It's an experience.
It's your chance to learn.
Not just about your field of study,
but who you are.
And what you believe.
As well as your place in the world.
It's your chance to make lifelong friends.
Take risks.
Discover your inner leader.
And create memories that'll last a lifetime.
And if that scares you,
that's okay.
Embrace that feeling and know that we're here for you.
Your advisors,
your faculty,
your peers.
We're all here to help guide you towards your dreams of success.
So take that first step on this journey.
Go to club meetings.
Drop into a center.
Attend an event.
Or even visit office hours.
And build those connections.
We did and found our homes.
On the track and in the field.
At the Asian and Pacific Islander Student Center.
At the Agriculture Farm Units. At the Black Resource Center.
Now it's your turn, Broncos.
Where will you find your home?
I'd like to introduce Dr. Jose Aguilar Hernandez. Dr. Aguilar Hernandez is a professor in the Department of Educational Leadership and is the proud son of immigrant farm workers from Zacatecas, Mexico. As a teacher scholar, Dr. Aguilar Hernandez has provided service and leadership in various transfer programs, including Cal Poly Pomona's Poly Transfer Program and the Educational Opportunity Program's Transfer Bridge. Please welcome Dr. Aguilar Hernandez to the stage.
Who's a new Bronco in the audience? Let's try that one more time. Who's a new Bronco in the audience? There you go. Thank you so much. President Coley, Provost Gomez, Vice President for Student Affairs Gonzalez, deans, associate deans, faculty, staff, and last but not least, incoming students. I am honored to welcome you on behalf of the faculty at Cal Poly Pomona to our first ever new student convocation. Today, we celebrate you, our newest members of the Bronco community. Congratulations on this major achievement. Give yourselves a round of applause for that. I also wish to congratulate and recognize your ancestors, families, teachers, counselors, and friends who are proud of you for working hard to reach this major achievement of being a college student at one of the best universities in the world, Cal Poly Pomona. We as faculty are ready to learn with you and to witness your growth during your time with us. This afternoon, as I look across the quad, I am reminded of my early days at Cal Poly Pomona as a new faculty member. I remember walking around during my job interview campus visit and being struck by the beauty of the campus and the hills and the mountains surrounding us. I recall seeing the workers tending to the trees, the grass, plants, and gardens. At that moment, I was reminded of my father, Esteban Aguilar Muro, an immigrant from Zacatecas, Mexico, who first migrated to the United States as a bracero, which translates to guest worker, during the post-World War II bracero program. My father eventually settled in the Ventura County, where I, the youngest of nine, was born. See, the reason that the workers reminded me of my father was because he was a farm worker who picked strawberries in the fields of Oxnard, California. I learned a lot about agriculture through him. After a long day of work, my father would arrive home looking tired, but that didn't stop him from sharing valuable lessons with me. On a few occasions, he raised his hands and told me, "Mira mis manos, estoy haciendo esto para ti," which translates to, "Look at my hands. I am doing this for you." My father's immigrant dream for me was that I work hard in school and graduate so that I could land an air-conditioned job. And here I am sweating under the sun. His dream, as someone who worked under the sun for most of his life, was that I access a job that paid better, so that I didn't struggle in the ways he did. I began my college trajectory at Moorpark Community College. Transfer students, where you at? All right, welcome. With the support of my EOPS counselors, I applied to four-year universities. One afternoon, I received the acceptance letter from my dream school, UCLA. I fondly remember sharing the news with my family. They were so proud of me. However, what I didn't share with my family was that I felt worried and guilty about leaving home. Since the age of 14, I had held various jobs to help my parents cover household expenses. During my first term at the university, my father mailed me a letter to my dorm. Inside the envelope was a $100 bill wrapped by a piece of paper where he had written the words, "Tenga mi hijo para que se ayude," which more or less translates to, "Son, here's some cash so that you can use it the way you need." I remember being initially angry because I knew that my father had retired, and I didn't want him to work during his retirement. I wanted him to rest. I called home, and luckily my sister answered the phone, and she explained that my father had returned to work in the fields of Oxnard to pick strawberries because he wanted to help me while I was in college. Those $100 were about half of his paycheck. My sister helped me understand that my father was doing this out of love for me. At that moment, I remembered the times my father showed me his hands after a day of picking strawberries. My father, despite only having a second grade education from Mexico, was teaching me important values that guided me through college and continue guiding me today as a professor. He taught me to work hard and to stay focused on my goal of getting my college degree. Before he passed away in 2005, I told him I wanted to go back to graduate school so that I could be a professor. And although he didn't get to see me physically as a professor, I know that he's proud of me. So let me ask you, who has supported your trajectory to being a college student? Who has offered you support or sent you encouraging texts or DMs? Who has told you that they believe in you? A parent, a guardian, a teacher, a counselor, a partner, a sibling, a grandparent, or someone like my father who passed away. Maybe someone passed away and didn't get to see you as a college student. Maybe you're thinking of multiple people. Hold them in your mind for a few seconds. They are so proud of you. Now that you've invoked your loved ones, let me share that your support system has multiplied significantly today by the mere fact that you are now a Bronco. Today, you are gaining, and I'm not kidding, you are gaining thousands of peers, faculty, staff, administrators, and new friends that want you to succeed. This network is important because sometimes college can be hard. But let me remind you that you already completed the requirements to be here. Before today, you already graduated from high school, and some of you from the community college as well, and you earned your place here. You belong here. I see you. You are a Bronco. So how will you make it through college when it gets rough? I want to share three tips with you. First, remain grounded in your purpose here. This purpose will serve as a compass, a map, a light at the end of the tunnel that will guide you through the highs and lows. Second, get to know your new academic home. I mentioned earlier that you already know what it takes to graduate, so apply those skills here. And when times get hard, reach out. We know what it takes to succeed, and we also likely experience what you go through. Third, remember to engage in campus activities. Join student clubs, go to faculty office hours, schedule appointments with your peer advisors and counselors, and attend the various events that my colleagues in student affairs put on. College is about earning your degree, which requires commitment to coursework, and college is also about learning beyond the classroom, with your peers, and in community spaces. I'd like to end by sharing another memory from my college days. On a particular weekend during my first year as a transfer student, I traveled home for a family gathering. That Friday night, I stayed up late in my old bedroom to work on a paper that was due the following week. It was past midnight, and I began to feel stressed, tired, and defeated. I recall thinking to myself, when will this paper be done? Am I doing it right? My sister, Esperanza, knocked on the door and walked in to check on me. Esperanza, which means hope in Spanish, is my best friend. When we were kids, she taught me to jugar a la escuelita, which means to play school. As the baby of the family, I was always the student, and she was always the teacher. That night, Esperanza heard my fears and stress. And as a maestra, teacher, sister, and best friend will always do, she lovingly reminded me, you got this. So in the words of my sister Esperanza, and in the spirit of the lessons of my ancestors, including my father, Esteban, Broncos, you got this. Thank you so much for your time, and welcome to the Bronco family.
Thank you, Dr. Aguilar Hernandez. Now we'd like you to take out the Broncos Belong enamel pin you received on your chair when you arrived. I'd like to invite your ASI Vice President, Megan Shadrick, to the podium for this pinning ceremony. As ASI leaders, both Megan and I will be serving you this year. As a whole, student government always aims to serve you, from lobbying on your behalf with state legislators, to advocating campus services and implementing fun events. Now please remove the pin from the card and turn to your neighbor to the left or right. You are now going to pin each other, if able. Ask your neighbor where they'd like their pin to be placed and carefully place it, just like this. This pin is a symbol of your new identity. It represents your commitment to academic excellence, integrity, and the pursuit of knowledge. When you are pinned, you are being welcomed into a community that values belonging. This act signifies that you are not alone on this journey. You have a network of peers, faculty, and staff who are here to support and guide you. Congratulations to each of you. You are now officially part of the Bronco family. As you wear your pins, wear them with pride, and remember the commitment you have made to yourself and to your community. With that, stand up and give yourselves a round of applause. You have officially joined the Bronco family.
Okay, I'm gonna say we are. I wanna hear Bronco. Ready? We are.
Bronco.
We are.
Bronco.
We are.
Bronco.
Okay, you can sit down. I'm so honored to be here in front of you today, and I'm gonna do something a little bit different. You're now part of the Bronco family. That includes your extended families, we consider also part of our Bronco family. There's a lot that'll be happening, not only over the next few days, the next few weeks, but the next few years. So I'd like you to trust me Put your phone down on your lap. I promise it's only for a couple minutes. And if you're able, I'd like you to close your eyes. Take a deep breath, in through the nose, out through the mouth. In through the nose one more time, out through the mouth. Now imagine yourself, you're starting your journey here at Cal Poly Pomona. You have a mix of excitement, maybe a little nervous, maybe there's some fear. Picture the campus around you, the tall trees, the bustling walkways, new faces all around. You're here because you earned it. You belong here, and this is just the beginning. I need you to hear that. You earned it. You belong here. Later this week, you'll attend your first club resource fair. You're not sure what to do. You're feeling a little anxiety. Are you going to meet the right people? Will you be making friends? Fast forward a few months. Imagine that you're sitting in a class that you find challenging. The materials, the things the professor is talking about, may feel overwhelming or very new to you. But you take a deep breath, you seek out resources and support, like a tutor or the care center. You connect with your classmates. You decide to take off your earbuds and talk to other students after class or talk to your professor. You even take off your earbuds when you're having lunch or dinner so that you can meet new people and connect. And slowly but surely, it starts to make sense. You see yourself growing, learning, and pushing through challenges. You ran into some personal obstacles, but you reached out for help from the many campus resources. You utilized the Learning Resource Center with your writing, the library to learn how to research. When you got to CPP, you told yourself you wanted to challenge yourself and have a different experience. Picture yourself stepping out of your comfort zone, joining groups you'd never have tried in high school. Maybe it's intramurals, student government, the hiking club, research with a professor, or attending an athletic event. You're challenging yourself to explore new interests, meet different people, and become a part of the vibrant campus community. With each new experience, you discover more about yourself and what you're capable of. The first year is ending. You are very proud of what you have achieved. Imagine looking back at your first exams, your first study group, your first campus event. You've made friends, built relationships with professors. You found your rhythm. You know what you need to do. You know that taking notes looks a little bit different. The second year ends, and you're proud of what you've achieved. Yes, there were challenges. You had to learn to study differently. You had to read a book from front to back. Imagine looking back at your first exams, your first study group. All of those pieces start coming together. As the years pass, you face new challenges, maybe a tough internship interview that you need to prepare for. The Career Center can help with that. A project that seems impossible, or a moment that you doubt your path. Picture these moments and see yourself finding strength, reaching out for support, and overcoming each challenge. You discover passions you didn't know you had. You find out that you're very good at some things you had no idea, and you grow more confident in your abilities. Now imagine the joy of your first big success, a project well done, a leadership role you've taken on, or an opportunity you've seized. Picture the sense of accomplishment and how it propels you forward, giving you the energy to take on even more. You're now in your final year. You've become a mentor to others. You've built lifelong friendships, and you've created memories that will stay with you forever. Imagine the pride you feel as you prepare for what comes next, the excitement of the future, and the gratitude for all the experiences at Cal Poly Pomona that shaped you. Finally, see yourself on graduation day, wearing your cap and gown. Picture yourself walking across this very stage, hearing your name, and feeling the weight of all your hard work coming to fruition. The applause surrounds you, the music, and you look out to see the faces of those who supported you along the way. This is your moment, the culmination of your resilience, dedication, and growth. As you open your eyes, remember this vision. Keep it with you as you navigate your time here, knowing that every challenge is an opportunity to grow, that you are not alone. You have support from many offices that have been mentioned today, and every success is a step closer to that moment when you walk across this stage. This is exactly the stage that you will be walking across, with your diploma in hand, ready to take on the world. Go Broncos.
Thank you for attending Broncos Belong. It's time for some fun at the celebration. You will soon be escorted to the engineering meadow. Please remain seated until you are instructed to exit and follow instructions by staff members. I invite Mace Bearer Dr. Aguilar Hernandez to retrieve the mace and lead the academic party in recessional.